One of the most common questions I get from patients is, how can I increase my semen volume? Well, I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today I'm going to teach you all about semen. How exactly does your body make it? What happens when you ejaculate? And why would you have a decreased semen volume? Does it bother your partner? And lastly, what are ways to increase your semen volume? Let's get to it. So semen is made up of a number of different components. Of course, everyone knows about sperm, which is made in the testes. So what percent of semen do you think is actually made up of sperm? Pause right now, comment below, and let me know what your guess is. It's actually 5%. So only 5% of your entire semen volume is sperm. A lot of people might actually think, you know, if their semen volume is less than someone else's, that maybe their sperm are not working as well or they're not as fertile as someone else. Well, that's absolutely untrue. The other components that make up your sperm include your prostate, which makes prostatic secretions, which work to kind of nourish and transport or help make the sperm mobile. And that is about 20 to 30% of the semen volume. And then the largest portion is from the seminal vesicles, which is about 60 to 70%. And these are these two little sac-like structures that are behind the prostate, and they hold the semen in them. And lastly, right before ejaculation, a very small amount comes from these tiny little glands right next to the urethra or the pee tube called the bulbourethral glands. Also, you may be wondering, how do some people have a more forceful ejaculation while some people may notice more of a dribble? Well, that's because you have these muscles around the urethra called the bulbocavernosus muscle. And when you ejaculate, these form kind of a rhythmic contraction, which causes the semen to propel or force forward. And these muscles can be stronger in some and weaker in others. And so that is what differentiates the force of the semen volume coming out. So now that you know what's normal and how your body works, you may be wondering, well, am I gonna ruin my relationship if the force of my ejaculate is weak or the volume is low? Well, in 2018, they did a study of 240 women and they asked them a bunch of questions about how they felt about their partner's ejaculate and how that played into their sexual pleasure. And what they found was that the large majority of women didn't care how much volume or force was behind the ejaculate. Only 17% of women said that their orgasm was actually stronger if their partner's orgasm was also noticeably strong. And an even smaller number, 13%, felt that maybe they were less attractive and that's why their partner wasn't having a strong ejaculation. So they actually had some self-esteem concerns because of their partner's ejaculate volume. So overall, I would say if you're worried about this, don't. The large majority of people are happy, especially if both parties are climaxing. There's really nothing to complain about. So why does semen volume decrease? Well, if you look at men over their entire age range, you'll find that the men who have the strongest and most voluminous ejaculate are those in their 30s. And then it continues to decline over age. And there's a number of factors that play into this. It can include the weakness of their muscles, as well as their diet, some lifestyle factors like smoking and other medical problems that can play a role as well. Interestingly, even day to day, your semen volume can vary because of a number of different things, how hydrated you are, potentially how much stress you're under, and what medications you're on. But what if you notice a sudden drop in your semen volume that doesn't go away? What do you do? What are some causes of this? Well, you might have an obstruction in the tube that carries the semen to the urethra for the ejaculation called the ejaculatory duct, or you may have a low testosterone. Other things that can cause this are certain medications, which the most common of which is called Tamsulosin or Flomax. And we often prescribe that to patients who have an enlarged prostate and might have difficulty emptying their bladder and have urinary symptoms. And this actually causes retrograde ejaculation. And what that is when you ejaculate, instead of moving forward, it actually goes backwards into the bladder and then you pee it out later. And as this is one of the side effects of that medication, it can also be a side effect of diabetes, certain neurologic diseases, or spinal cord injuries. So if you're experiencing this sudden change, make sure you see a urologist to make sure you are not suffering from one of these causes. Now, on to four ways that you can increase your semen volume. I'm gonna give you the first three, which may help a little bit, and the fourth way, which has actually been proven to increase semen volume. So make sure you stick around till the end. Number one, quit smoking. Smoking is a horrible habit. Not only is it related to lung cancer and causes lung problems, it can also cause bladder cancer and be associated with erectile dysfunction. So if you want to keep your strong erections, quit smoking and don't smoke. And in theory, the thought is that it causes some nerve damage that causes decreased production of the secretions that create semen volume. So just another reason to get rid of that nasty habit. Number two, hydrate. Just like any other substance our body makes, you need a lot of hydration and fluid to make sure you're making a large amount. So make sure you're getting enough fluid. And a good way to check is take a look at your urine. If your urine's like a lemonade, light yellow, you're very well hydrated. Number three, do Kegel exercises. So I've talked about Kegel exercises before in my video, check it out. And I've mentioned that I don't think Kegel exercises are right for every single person. But if you don't have urinary symptoms, pelvic pain, and erectile dysfunction as a really young person, these exercises may actually be really helpful for you. And what they do is they actually strengthen those pelvic floor muscles, including the bulbo cavernosus muscle, which makes the force of the ejaculation stronger. So you're actually more completely emptying your semen volume. So while you're not making more, you're just getting more of it out. So nothing gets left behind. Before I move on to number four, I will say that there are no FDA-approved supplements to increase your semen volume. So a lot of supplements will say, yes, we'll increase your semen volume. Definitely, you'll see it 100%. But at this time, we don't have any good data to suggest that there is one magic supplement that's going to do that for you. Number four, onto the most surefire way to increase your semen volume is to ejaculate less frequently. The reason is, if you have more time between ejaculations, you'll have more time to fill up the tank. They actually studied this. They took 27 guys. They collected semen samples from them every month for 16 months. And they asked them how long they'd waited or been abstinent before ejaculating, and collected all this data, and they looked at the variations in semen volume. And what they found was that for each day a person remained abstinent or waited to ejaculate, they increased their semen volume by 10%. And if you look at those that waited for 4 days or less, it was actually 12% on each of those days. And after 4 days, it went down to about 7 to 8%. So yeah, absolutely. If you wait a couple days, you will have more semen volume when you ejaculate. All right, that's it. Thank you so much for watching today. And as always, remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.